All right, let's get back to the breaking news. The Deputy Attorney General Rod Rosenstein has just resigned. His resignation comes as the Attorney General William Barr's scheduled testimony in front of the House Judiciary Committee on Thursday morning might actually be unraveling. Let's bring back our political experts for some analysis. Jackie, first of all, let's talk about Rod Rosenstein. We all have the letter now. His resignation goes into effect May 11th.
Yeah, and as we were just joking about, this is almost the second time he's resigned. But Rosenstein has been really an enigma throughout the Trump presidency. Really difficult guy to understand, especially as more and more anecdotes have come out from behind the scenes. You know, he's a guy who volunteered potentially to wear a wire to record what the president was doing behind the scenes. But then he's also the same person who the Washington Post just reported last week was also tried to mollify Trump in terms of the Mueller report, saying that he was going to be able to land the plane here. The line that really stands out to me here is him quoting John Ashcroft for, conducting, overseeing a professional Justice Department free from politics, right? This comes right after Trump called the FBI scum on Saturday.
Dirty
so,
cops.
Despite this letter, I'm not sure Rosenstein has done the most in order to make sure that the Justice Department is isolated from politics, as he's so claiming here.
I'm not sure anybody can, but it does seem that he offered some parting advice for the president. He said, quote, "We ignore fleeting distractions and focus our attention on the things that matter because a republic that endures is not governed by the news cycle." I almost feel like the subtext there is like, put down your phone
totally.
Occasionally.
Stop tweeting.
Yeah.
One other thing in the covering up the idea potentially that he's leaving early. I love when they do. The median tenure of a deputy attorney general is 16 months, and few serve longer than 2 years, which is essentially, I'm not being forced out. Everything's cool. I'm leaving when they basically leave. But Jackie's point about him being an enigma is fascinating because he is the guy who establishes the special counsel. He is the guy who stays and kind of protects the special counsel broadly, Don McGahn also. But he's also the guy who, when Bill Barr gives the press conference before the Mueller report, an hour and a half before the Mueller report comes out, he's the guy doing this. Standing next to him. And Barr says, Deputy Attorney General Rosenstein and I decided jointly not to pursue obstruction. So, you can, in some ways, you can make what you want of him. You can make him a hero or a devil either way in this story. But he's one thing you can't dispute. He's absolutely at the center of this. And now that it's concluded, at least that part of it, he's leaving. This is not hugely surprising.
Let's not forget, he was often either directly or indirectly attacked by the president.
Yeah, I agree, though, with Chris. He's either a hero or a goat, depending on what you look at. The tone of this letter is so lofty and opaque as to be almost absurd, Wolf. So let's just talk about two things. One, in terms of what you just said, right, the special counsel was allowed to complete his work, and Rod Rosenstein had a role in that. So perhaps he did play a key role in having justice brought out at least that far. On the other hand, the way he handled Wolf, the firing of Jim Comey, authoring the May 9th memo that gave Hillary Clinton as a plausible reason why Jim Comey should be let go by a Republican president. I think he got rolled by the Trump White House. I don't
by
know any other way to
himself?
See by the
in
president
the
himself. I don't know any other way to see it. So again, hero or goat, I don't know.
The thing about him is he's so central, and yet we don't really. And there's been so much reporting about him, but he doesn't, with the exception of the speech last week, he doesn't talk publicly all that much. And so there's so much that we don't know because, well, he was alleged to have offered to wear a wire, bringing up the 25th Amendment. They say he was joking. There's reporting that says he was a jury. You can't pin him down because he's not waiting. I guess the Rosenstein memoir. I mean, it probably is not that far away, but like,
there's a book, I think, in the future.
Let's see if he testifies before the House and/or Senate Judiciary Committee sometime down the road. Speaking of testimony before the House Judiciary Committee, you just heard Congressman Steve Cohn say that the Attorney General might be chicken to go before the committee on Thursday because staff lawyers will be asking some questions.
Right. Of the things that are going to scare Bill Barr, I don't think Steve Cohen's comments are the ones to do it, calling him out and chicken and getting in a name-calling contest. But I think Jerry Nadler seemed pretty certain that a subpoena would be coming Bill Barr's way if he could not indeed reach an agreement about coming and testifying before the House Judiciary Committee. And then, as you know, we could see this potentially end up in the courts. This is part potentially if Barr says, I'm not coming, I don't like your rules. I think this goes into a list of things that the Trump administration has now going where they're just going to try and stonewall this new Democratic majority in the House. Yep.
Yeah, and I think, you know, what is so fascinating to me also about Rosenstein's exit is that speech that he gave last week to the, I think, the police association in New York, which really, you know, he sort of unleashed this Pandora's box begging Democrats to subpoena everyone involved with the Mueller report after he said it was just the tip of the iceberg in terms of Russian interference, which should really be the priority for most of the federal government going
and
into 2020.
Which Steve Cohen noted in that in your interview with him.
Exactly. And so I sort of feel like this is, you know, the Trump administration almost a double dog daring Congress to continue to call them in. But, you know, there is really little incentive, I think, for the White House to cooperate here after the Mueller report's already been rolled out and they've already shown their appearances of cooperation.
We're going to have a lot more on all of this. Everybody stand by.